So welcome to the next chapter of mathematics, and that's ratio and proportion. Basically, we are going to consider a few real life examples which will help you to understand what is the ratio and what is the proportion. Then we'll also discuss what is the difference between ratio and proportion. Okay, so let's start with the basics. Actually, imagine you are at a restaurant with your friend. You two have ordered a pizza. Pizza is in the standard format, cut into 8 parts. Suppose you are very much hungry and your friend is rather a best friend to you. Since you are very, very hungry, your friend allows you to eat 5 pieces. So you eat 5 and your friend eats obviously remaining 3. So how do we compare how much have you eaten versus aapke dost ne kitna khaya? So this is you versus your friend. How much have you eaten? You ate 5, your friend ate 3. We are familiar with this sign. This is the sign of ratio. So a ratio is indicated with this sign and is read as 5:3. So if I tell you that jitna maine khaya versus mere friend ne jitna khaya, uska ratio aa raha hai 5:3, to aap immediately bolenge ke isne zyada khaya aur isne kam khaya. Okay, so who ate more? This one ate more, your friend ate less. Clearly, ratio ka pehla application seekh liya hai humne. The ratio helps you to compare. It helps you to compare. Compare what? Compare what? It helps you to compare. It helps you to compare what? Think for a second. Is used to compare the quantities of, it helps you to compare the quantities of different categories. Different categories. What are the categories I'm talking about basically? Here in this case, it was pieces of pizza. Okay. In some cases it will be total number of human beings se matlab, number of men and number of women. So men and women, arre, men and women. Or it can also be anything like number of hot days and cold days. So it can be anything like that. So you get to compare different categories. You can also compare the categories of salary, that salary of A versus salary of B. So definitely once you see the ratio, you understand comparative basis pe ki kiska share zyada hai aur kiska share kam hai. Let me give you one more example. Suppose this is you and friend. Abhi in any other scenario, suppose now this time your friend is very hungry. Your friend is very hungry and you guys are best friend of course. So out of 8 pieces you let your friend have basically 6 pieces. So your friend had 6, you had 2, and the ratio would be you is to friend ka ho jayega 2:6. Abhi sequence would matter, huh? You is to friend ho jayega 2:6. So clearly friend is to you kaise bataungi main? Friend is to you कैसे बताऊंगी मैं? 6:2. ओके, सो द सीक्वेंस मैटर्स. क्लियरली किसने ज्यादा खाया? ऑब्वियसली द फ्रेंड एट मोर. रेशियो आ रहा है 2:6 यू एंड फ्रेंड का. ओके, देर इज वन मोर पॉइंट आई वुड लाइक टू एम्फसाइज हियर, दैट इफ देर इज अ कॉमन मल्टीपल ऑफ दीज टू, or rather there is a common factor of these two. So I can divide that and definitely I can reduce my ratio. अभी भी comparison वही है that you and friend के बीच में the comparison is 1:3. Whereas in reality आपने दो pieces खाए हैं versus आपके friend ने 6 of them खाए हैं. So clearly this is nothing but 1:3. So I hope this is very very clear, not really that difficult. So you as to friend का comparison हो गया 1:3. So suppose this time there are three friends going. Just imagine A is to B is to C. There are three friends going. There is one pizza order. Now A eats 2, B eats 5, C eats just 1. So the ratio will be A as to B as to C would be 2:5:1. So it's easy to compare. 2:5:1, who ate more? B ate more. A ate 2, C just ate 1. So I hope this is clear. 2:5:1. So ye ho gaya A ka hissa. A. So ये हो गया B का हिस्सा. This is B. And the blank one is C. So this is how I compare. I have also discussed how to reduce the ratios. So here it was 2:6. Then we divided each one by 2. And the ratio was reduced to 1:3. So I hope this is very very clear. That the ratio can be reduced, it can be used to compare, and there can be more than two quantities which can be compared in the ratio. Ratio may we compare different quantities, different categories rather, and their quantities where pieces of pizza could be there. There can be men or women, there can be hot days and cold days. And so these are the applications of ratios. Okay, it definitely expresses using this one, colon. It is definitely expressed using colon. Okay, then I'm going to the third one now. It expresses quantitative relationship between two categories. जैसा कि मैंने बोला, we can compare quantities. It can express quantitative relationship between two categories. जैसे men and women, girls and boys, hot days versus cold days. So this is how we define ratio basically. Let's go towards the next point about the ratio. If I'm telling you A is to B is my ratio, A is known as antecedent. A is known as antecedent and B is known as consequent. A is known as antecedent, B is known as consequent. There is one more way of expressing it. A as to B can also be expressed as A/B, which means A divided by B, which means it can be expressed as division of two quantities. So let me give you an example. If I'm talking about 2:3, A will be my antecedent, B will be my consequent. The same can be rewritten as 2/3, that is division of two quantities. Even this is the way using which I can express the ratio. Okay, the next point now. Ratio of only similar quantities, ratio of only same quantities can be actually compared. So, similar quantities or other similar categories, I must say, similar categories with same units, similar categories with same units. What do you mean by that? You cannot take ratio of 10 girls with 50 mangoes. It's not allowed. Why? Because girls and mangoes are two completely different categories. I can take ratio of 10 girls with say 50 girls in class B, 10 girls in class A, possible. Then 10 girls in class A with that even 20 boys in class A, same class, that's possible. Why? Because the category is same and the category is human beings. Okay, the category is human beings. Once the category is same, you can always take a ratio. There is a comparison possible. How will you compare girls with mangoes? It's impossible to compare. You cannot compare two quantities though that are not similar and that are not belonging to the same kind of a category. Okay. So they should have similar categories. Then the next point of discussion, the most important one, is before we take a ratio, both the quantities, that is here A and B, these ones, both the quantities, bracket me likh deti hu, A and B, must be expressed in same unit. What do you mean by that? I cannot take a ratio of 1 kilometer to 500 meter. That's impossible. Either I need to convert 500 meter, rather meter to kilometer, or I'll have to convert kilometer to meter. So before I take any ratio, the quantities must be expressed in same unit. Okay. So either both can be kilometer or both can be meter. So same unit. But after you do that, the next one and the very important point is, the final ratio does not have any unit. Final ratio does not have any unit. Okay. Why? So I'm just trying to compare who did more and who did less. Suppose A got 100 marks, B got 50 marks. So the ratio is going to be 100:50. Then I will divide both of them by 50. I have already told that if it has a common factor, it's definitely possible to divide. So the comparison would be A ko B se twice marks mile hai. So A is performing better. How much better? Twice as better as B. So the final ratio will not have a unit. It's just a comparison. Who did better and who did not? I hope I'm clear.